Hello, and welcome to the next lecture for Applied Statistics and Probability for Engineers. Let's continue then with our discussion about graphical techniques for displaying data. A histogram is a purely graphical representation of the stem and leaf plot. Observations are divided into intervals, often called intervals, cells, or bins. So bins are typically of equal sizes or width. There's no set formula for determining the number of bins, but the number of bins should increase with the number of samples and should be selected as to provide a useful description of the scatter in a compact manner. The number of observations in each bin represent the frequency with which the observation occurs. The number of observations in each bin may be divided by the total number of observations to give a relative frequency. Here's an example of a histogram. A simple example of a histogram is test results. If we were to split test scores from a class into equal interval of 10 points each, these are our bins. Then we would know how many students scored within these 10-point increments. As a teacher, this is useful to visualize so we can see, oh, the most amount of students scored between this number and this number. In this case, we can look at these specific 10-point increments. So here we have 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, and so on. So just by looking at this, we can say, okay, the most amount of students in my class scored between 50 to 60 points on the test. These graphical displays are also easier to draw by hand. You will have some homework assignments asking you to create a histogram. You can do this in Excel if you happen to have the statistics add-on tool pack, but it's usually just easier to draw by hand. There are also online histogram generators, so you can do whatever you are most comfortable with for the homework. Pareto charts are a variation of the histogram where the observation bins are ordered from highest to lowest frequency. The Pareto chart is commonly used in quality control studies where the frequency of defects is sorted by category, in other words, the bins. The reason it's called a Pareto chart is that Pareto's law is an observation that typically most of the defects are found in a few categories which can easily be determined from the Pareto chart. So let's see what these look like. Here's an example of a Pareto chart. So once again, they're a variation of a histogram where the observation bins are ordered from highest to lowest frequency, meaning the bins with the highest observations are ordered first, or put first, and then in descending order. So here, this is a graph of reasons why people arrive late to things. So you notice our bins are traffic, childcare, public transportation, weather, they overslept, or an emergency happened. So here, out of all these people that were surveyed, we have maybe 55 that said it was because of traffic, and then 40-something that said because of childcare, and so on. So it's similar to a histogram in that we graph the frequency on the y-axis, but this time we're going to put the highest bin first. The line at the top of the graph is a point-to-point graph which shows the cumulative relative frequency. So if you notice over here, their units are in terms of percentages. So we take whatever percentage said traffic, so we would take 55 out of 168. We would find that percentage, which is about a third, and then we would add that to whatever percentage is said childcare, and then add that to whatever percentage said public transportation, and so on until we equaled 100%. This is superimposed on the bar graph so we can easily visualize the percentages of each value. Because the values of the statistical variables are placed in order of frequency, the graph clearly reveals which factors have the greatest impact and where attention is likely to yield the greatest benefit. So in this case, we could look at this and say, okay, most of our employees were late because of traffic today, so maybe we're a little lenient because it wasn't an individual case.